In today's video, we'll be talking about how to compress videos without losing the video quality. If you enjoy mobile-related content like this one, please subscribe to the channel so you won't miss out on all the pro tips that I'll be dropping in subsequent videos. Let's jump right in. If you are the type that shoots videos a lot for the internet, you will discover that the file size of most videos, even if it is shot from your mobile phone, sometimes can get very large and difficult to upload. So you might want to reduce the file size at least so that it will be manageable. So for you to be able to do that, you will need some tools. You need at least an Android app to enable you to do that. Let's jump into a screen recording to see how I was able to bring down a 600 megabytes file to about 150 megabytes. Let's jump into the screen recording. To reduce video file size without losing video quality, you look for a video compression app called Video Compress, because my example today will be based on Video Compress. So you go to Play Store, download Video Compress, click on open, and please be informed that this app is filled with ads, right? So many adverts everywhere. That's why I had to enable Blockada. So for you to be able to use the app without being troubled with so many ads, you need to download and install Blockada on your device. Okay, so let's go back to what we're doing. Now we have opened Video Compress. Click on camera if you want to compress a video that you shot on your camera. And for this example, I'm going to compress this video that is about 685 megabytes. We are going to see how far down we can bring the file size of that video. So we tap on that. Tap on compress video is the first option on the top left. Compress video. Now there are different settings you can use to compress your video. I would like us to use custom settings, because when you go to custom, it gives you the leeway to do whatever you want with your video. You can choose to reduce the video file size based on the video resolution, or you can choose to reduce the file size based on bitrate. Now I would advise that you use both, okay? Right now we are having a 1080p footage with a relatively high bitrate. As we reduce the bitrate, you can see that the file size is going down on the frame on the right. So let's drop it to 50% bitrate. Now what bitrate actually means? Bitrate refers to the amount of detail that is available per pixel. So as you are reducing the bitrate, you are actually reducing the amount of detail in every single pixel of your video. In a talking head video, there are not so many moving parts in a video, so even with a reduced bitrate, the loss of quality will not be visible. You can have a 1080p video at a 50% less bitrate, you will not notice the loss of detail. Except maybe if you are watching it on a TV, that is when you might possibly notice. Of course, most people who consume video, online video, are consuming it from their mobile phone. So they are very, very likely not to notice the difference. But at least you have dropped the video size by half. So if you now want to reduce the resolution, you can still go ahead and reduce that from 1080p to say 720p. Now at 720p, you notice that the file size has dropped to about a third. So once you have adjusted the settings to get the file size you wanted, you can either slide down or slide up depending on what you want. If you want to further reduce the bitrate, you can, but just know that it's going to affect the video a little bit. So the more you reduce the bitrate, the more your video quality is going to take a hit. So it is better to have a low resolution video with a high bitrate than to have a high resolution video with a low bitrate. So please take note of that. If you have a high resolution video with a low bitrate, it's going to look worse than a low resolution video with a high bitrate. So you can slide it down to 720p so that you can still have a good picture quality and the video size has been dropped to about a third. So having done that, we can now hit compress video. It's going to take some time to compress. Once it's compressed, we will see the output. If you've watched up to this point, I believe you'll be able to compress videos of any size whenever it is necessary. So if this video was useful to you, please smash the like button and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next video.